I have opened a tethered session in Capture One, and the server is set up and operating.
The empty space on the iPad indicates we're currently looking into an empty Capture folder. Let's take a test shot and see what happens. As you could hear from the sound of the shutter, the transfer of the capture from camera to Capture One and onto the iPad is extremely fast. The result isn't quite what I wanted, so I'll make a few changes in Capture One using the exposure and white balance controls. The changes are almost instantly visible on the iPad. If I keep the Copy from Last feature active, the changes I have made will be automatically applied to the next photos, but instead, let's add a style. We'll try a blue tone. As you can see, not only are the captures visible on the iPad, they are arriving with the style automatically applied. The iPad viewer includes a small histogram in the corner, so everyone can reassure themselves that the exposure is good. But if this is too complicated for your clients, you can click the histogram icon to hide it. The arrows allow the user to browse the folder, or, of course, you can just use your fingers as you'd expect to with an iPad or iPhone.
Remember, this tool is not an editor, rather a really useful viewer that will have many applications both in and out of the studio.